Okay. Hello, everyone. I'm Raj. I'm excited to be here to talk about HP Helion OpenStack. We are going to do a couple of demos here. I lead the product management efforts for HP Helion OpenStack Community Edition that was just announced last week. And I have Chris here. Chris, do you want to introduce yourself?
Yeah, hello. My name is Chris Frank. I'm from our European operations of HP Cloud, and I work in pre-sales.
Thanks, Chris, for joining me today. And Chris is going to help me with the demo of both Community Edition, and also he's going to walk through the public cloud capabilities. So we'll cover both of that. And hopefully we can get all this done in the 30 minutes or so. Then the remaining 15 minutes, we can open it up for questions. We have a couple of folks, SMEs from the products that we're demoing, worked on, will join us towards the end, so you can hear from them directly. So that's a plan. Okay, can we get started? So again, I want to, hopefully you guys got this book by Lisa, who's still, I think, signing these books in the back. And my favorite graphic, I want to show you the favorite graphic. This is the three caged clouds on top of Seattle Space Needle. You can figure out which are those clouds. We definitely want HP Cloud to be one of them for sure. There are three major play. You know, Seattle is becoming a big cloud center, and you have probably seen the news that HP is hiring a lot in Seattle. So this is my favorite graphic. Okay. So we'll get started. So you would have heard us telling this message again and again, and I want to remind everyone that HP is really betting big on the future of cloud. We think it's really hybrid. It's hybrid cloud. The new enterprise IT mandate is really, it's going to be hybrid. It's not just going to be private, or it's not just going to be public. I know public cloud has a lot of mindshare today, but based on what we're seeing and what we're hearing from customers and all the data, the hybrid cloud is really going to be the future. You're going to see more and more hybrid cloud deployments. So I want to tell a little bit of, we'll cover all aspects of this cloud spectrum here. You already know that we have HP is already a leader in private cloud. In Forrester Magic Quadrant, you would have seen that we are number one in terms of private cloud solution and products. So we have something called Cloud System that's really doing very well in the market. So that's fantastic. But here, today we are not going to talk about that. I'm here to talk about OpenStack-based distribution that we call it as Community Edition, that allows anyone to actually experience OpenStack, consume it in a very easy way, and deploy a small-scale private cloud. So we think we have a really good private cloud solution that will push us even further in terms of leadership. And of course, the public cloud side, HP runs one of the largest OpenStack-based public cloud. We are really happy that we have that, because a lot of the experience and expertise that we have in running that high-scale cloud is really helping us in building products like Community Edition. So with this, we think we have some of the products out there like CSA that really allows you to kind of stitch together private and public cloud and kind of have a single view of the whole thing, and you kind of see all of that as one resource pool. The IT administrators in your enterprise can get a good view of where all your deployments are, and so we have a lot of products that's kind of stitching together these two. So hybrid IT hybrid cloud is going to be the feature, and we are here really to be a leader in that space. Okay. So how many of you heard about our announcement on HP Helion OpenStack Community Preview last week? Very good. How many of you have downloaded it and tried out? It's pretty good. I see Peter raising his hands. Okay. So if you have not, I mean, it's really, you should jump on it right now. We today morning, there was an announcement about OpenStack Foundation's Marketplace. If you go to openstack.org/marketplace, HP Helion, in the distros tab, HP Helion Community Edition is kind of featured prominently. So you cannot really miss it. You should go, just download it today and give it a try. So I had some more slide that I created for download URL and stuff, but it's all of it is live in OpenStack.org now. So what is OpenStack community, HP Helion OpenStack Community Edition, right? It is a free to license and a download OpenStack distribution from HP. This is our, you know that Monty talked about all the great stuff that we do in OpenStack. HP has been a significant player in OpenStack. You guys know that in terms of, lines of code contribution, we are like number two all time, more than 1 million lines of code. We have 4 PTLs handling critical projects in OpenStack. We are number two in terms of reviewers, I believe. Like we are in number two, number three, number one in some cases. So we are doing a lot of that in the community. But we want to be able, we're not going to stop there. We want to come to you in the future and really talk about in the future summits about number of OpenStack deployments out there that HP has helped, right? Number of servers that have OpenStack enabled, things like that. So we really have big plans in terms of taking this great technology and productizing it and taking it to solving real customer problems out there. So that's really our goal. To that end, we are showing our commitment by introducing our first OpenStack distribution. This is first time we are actually releasing a distribution. And I'm very excited to say that it's based on Icehouse release, which, but when we released this last week, it was just barely 3 weeks after the Icehouse release. So that's how fast we are pushing our teams to move and get these products out. So really kudos to the team. We worked really hard to get this out, and we are super encouraged by the response that we are seeing because this is the first distribution based on Icehouse, and it's based on OOO for deployment. For those of you who are new, OOO is OpenStack on OpenStack. It's basically using OpenStack to deploy OpenStack. So you'll kind of get a taste of that here today, but it's based on OOO. So that's another fantastic thing. What that means is we are not really some of our competitors' distributions. We are not investing in our own proprietary deployment technology, or we're not going to add a lot of HP code here. I mean, our goal is to really give you a pure OpenStack, and where it's needed, we might add some code to make it easy, make your life easy, but we are committed to making all of that open source. So for the full release, you will notice that in addition to the download, you will also be able to actually download the entire source code of whatever packages that that is part of this distribution, including HP's hardened Linux. We basically have our own hardened Linux host operating system for this distribution, which again shows our commitment that we really want to own this full stack end to end, and we are not going to take dependency on third parties for managing the quality or our agility in terms of how fast we want to ship this product. So that's a pretty big deal actually. So that also ships with this preview. And finally, not a lot of distributions out there are offering this kind of support. We'll talk more about it later, but it's really, you can get support from HP. You can purchase support per node per year. You'll hear more details of it as we release a full product. But that's going to give you, access to HP's OpenStack technical experts, which is a great thing. But in addition to that, we also announced it's going to qualify you for indemnification, which is a big deal. It's really we're making a big differentiation there in terms of having HP support for legal issues that you may or may not. I mean, it's just you'll feel lot more safer with this kind of support and from HP. So we are really excited about that. Again, we announced last May 7th. We announced the preview version. It's available to download for the last 5 days. So if you have not done it, please go and download it today. I don't know how it's going to do in wireless network here, but when you get a chance, try and it's a pretty big package. So it's going to take a while. So I would probably recommend downloading in a wired network. Okay. And as we said, we are committed to shipping every 6 weeks. So the next release in June, 6 weeks. Will basically be the feature complete in terms of We'll talk more about it again in the next couple of slides. We'll tell you exactly what are the new features that you can expect in that release. Okay. So for now, we want to talk about what we have today and the community preview. This is how the deployment topology, the deployment steps look like. It's really, really simple. We could walk through the commands, but we made it so simple that it's not a lot of fun to show what commands it is to deploy it. So I actually posted a video, a YouTube video of the full deployment walkthrough, which takes roughly 10 to 15 minutes, depending on your capacity of your laptop or server. I posted that video in Twitter. I think it got retweeted by HP Helion Cloud. You should go take a look. That gives you the full step-by-step walkthrough, right? It's literally three steps. Step number one, once you get the tarball file, unzip it, step number one, you start the seed VM, right? That takes it's really fast. Then you deploy under cloud, deploy over cloud. Literally, those are the steps. You have a simple private cloud, cloud in a box up and running. So it's fantastic, right? That's how simple it is. We looked at some of our competitive distros. I think we kind of beat everyone in terms of number of steps to deploy this. So it's really easy to go get it, give it a try. And then this also ships with a guest VM that you can try out. It's based on Debian. So that's how it looks like. Instead of actually walking through the full deployment and making you all sit and watch the monitor for like 15, 20 minutes, we have a deployed version up and running, and Chris is going to now show you that actually how that looks like and kind of walk through. Okay, go ahead. Should we switch?
Well, we can just exit out. So
thanks, Chris.
My pleasure. Let me first walk you through a couple of the steps. Come on. Hello. So, what I want to, coming back to what you were saying, we have two machines that we run. We run the undercloud that gives us the environment to deploy the clouds from, and then from that we actually deploy the active cloud. If we look on our undercloud, which is the best way to show is actually using the terminal. We have a from heat the information, we have a complete stack. And then right here, you have the two overcloud controllers. So if we look at our undercloud, it shows us a complete heated stack implementation, and it gives us a Nova compute and the cloud controller, which has all the rest. We then switch, and look on our overcloud using the same commands, looking Nova list. You can see we have our demo machines. So that's how this whole triple O deployment stacks up. We have a seed, where we start implementing the kind of laying the foundation for the undercloud. We then start off an undercloud from which we deploy all the necessary components for the overcloud, Nova, Cinder, Neutron, whatever you want. In the initial version that you can currently download, it's two controllers. It's one main controller having Cinder, Neutron, and the others, and one Nova controller. As we move on, as this evolves, we'll continue to do that. Why do we do that? Just imagine you have your overcloud has a couple of Neutron controllers, a couple of Nova controllers, and you need more. But you want to add Nova computes. So you go to your undercloud and deploy them. Right? And that is how you can scale the cloud. So that's the beauty of OpenStack on OpenStack. So we're using OpenStack to actually scale out or scale down, but you never want to do that, scale out OpenStack. In addition to this, on the demo you have, and I love the menu, go, there it is. You have the Horizon interface. Horizon, it probably looks very familiar to you. It's branded, so it's the Helion Community Edition Horizon interface. It allows you to create your projects, to have instances, volumes, network storage, whatever you want. And you're probably very familiar with this. That's the ISOS version of Horizon. Key thing is you have the list of instances. We have two on here, one per default and one for a logout. What? We have Cinder volumes that we can create. Cinder volumes we then can attach to volumes to existing compute instances. But that's not novel. We have all seen this before. If you've worked with Horizon, the last thing I wanted to show you is the very standard network topology information of the demos that we created. If you go back to your compute projects, I'm not going through a launch instance, but again, that's standard. And you have this, Raj pointed it out, it takes probably less than an hour to set this up in the current demo version. Start the seed, create the undercloud, create your overcloud, and you're ready to deploy. Okay. Let me give you...
Thanks, Chris. So we have a HP booth downstairs with this deployment. So if you have access to go play around with this, so please do that when you get a chance. So what's coming for the final release? Not final release. Remember, there is no final release here. We're going to keep shipping every 6 weeks. So the next full release, the next release is going to have support for bare metal deployment, obviously for undercloud and overcloud nodes. You will be able to deploy a private cloud with up to 30 compute nodes. That's pretty good size private cloud. I mean, you can get it going. That's if you can get a rack of servers. That's we have a product actually for you to go try in a few weeks. We will ship representative architecture and hardware support matrix as we get started. You can expect us just the way we will iterate on the product. We will keep on adding more hardware support as well as we go along. Again, remember this is not going to be just tied to the HP hardware. It's going to be hardware agnostic, so you can expect us to have third-party hardware is also supported for this distribution, okay? We're going to have overcloud HA for sure. After trying this out, some folks are giving us feedback on, hey, are you doing this, are you doing that? So there's a lot of interest definitely in HA. We're going to have basic logging and monitoring. So remember, the goal is to really have you running it in small-scale private cloud product in production. So you got to have logging and monitoring to be able to do that. Then finally, the foundation care support I talked about, that's going to come in the future release as well. So what does this mean, support for HP Helion OpenStack Community Edition? What does foundation care means? It's really, it's going to give you direct access to interact with experts in HP's global center of expertise. It's going to have software support. It's going to help you with any installation issues, or if your environment is different, we will help you with the installation and help with software features. You don't understand how this works, and any operation support, all of that stuff will be taken care of for this. Again, like I said, this is going to be per server per year. We are not announcing any pricing today, but you can expect us to come talk more about it in future events. Okay. So yeah, I had the slide, but it's really this. You don't have to remember any of this long or short URL. Just go to OpenStack Marketplace, and you can download from there. I do want to mention about the OpenStack Community Forum. It's hosted in ask.openstack.org. It's not hosted in any HP site. Again, we wanted to really stay true to what this edition is. This is community edition. We want it to be, a lot of the discussion to happen in the community. So please do participate over there if you get to download and try this out. So again, so that's our private cloud and community edition specifics. Now we're going to switch to talk about HP Helion public cloud. And Chris is again going to take over from here and run through the rest of the presentation. Thanks.
Thank you. Before I go into the slides, I just thought maybe I'd show you something.
Yeah. Overcloud, undercloud. What is overcloud and undercloud? So overcloud is where the actual the workloads are running, right? Undercloud is supporting the overcloud. The seed cloud is what it is. I mean, it's basically it's a seed of bringing up the whole cloud. So once a cloud is deployed, seed cloud doesn't matter anymore, but undercloud and overcloud is where you actually your developers are going to interact, all the horizon, all the things that you saw there is all on overcloud. So again, it's all OpenStack, yeah. This triple O, this all is very specific to triple O. If you go to triple O, I encourage you to go to OpenStack triple O and take a look at some of these terms. But again, we're going to have some Q&A with experts. Actually, you can go deep in some of these questions, okay? Once we finish through this public cloud demo. Thanks.
Well, never do live demos. Okay, I stick to the slides.
Okay, that's fine. We'll go to the slide and
No, it's...
Do you have internet access?
We have internet access. I have the page, but it does not let me do this. Good. Let me try later. What I wanted to show you actually was the interface of the public cloud, which looks exactly like the private cloud, which makes the best case for hybrid. Because the interface of the Helion OpenStack, the Horizon, from the very menu down to the API, and the interface of our public cloud, they're absolutely identical. So there's seamless move of workloads between the two clouds. And not only between the two, in addition to private clouds, we can also do managed and virtual private clouds. Talking about our public cloud, the Helion public cloud has been around since Diablo. It's one of the biggest OpenStack-based commercial clouds. It's enterprise-grade. So we have monitoring. We run it 24/7. We have probably the most stringent SLAs in the industry. And it's one of the components of the full Helion cloud portfolio. We used to call it the converged cloud, starting with from traditional IT, private clouds, managed clouds, virtual public clouds, all of this, and the public implementation of it is the cloud that we currently run here. What do we offer? In the public cloud, I mean, we offer, of course, compute. That will be the basic OpenStack offering. We have cloud object storage, where you can buy Swift services from us in the cloud. We have a content delivery network where we work together with Akamai. We have cloud block storage, which is fairly new, so you can buy Cinder services from us. You can buy networking from us. And we have DNS as a service in the cloud that you can use to deliver DNS to you, to your own enterprise. In beta currently, we have cloud monitoring, and we have database as a service. These are currently in beta. We have a load balancer in beta. That's part of the cloud. And then we're starting on application platforms to put that into service. But the key is the cloud compute that we offer on the public cloud. It's the same compute that you get from any OpenStack installation. And you can have API access. So it is entirely possible to do a complete hybrid setup from a single point of view, either from our own cloud service automation or any other portal, to deploy workloads on a local cloud, a cloud that runs in the HP data centers just for you, or on our public cloud. Now it's all the same. It's one platform, one technology. Oops. There's one missing. Let me try that one thing again. But hpcloud.com. Sorry. Sick. Yes. So. So, I mean, just go with it. Yeah, you've probably seen that before many times. The Horizon interface on the public cloud, absolutely identical, same command lines, Nova create, same way of attaching volumes, ephemeral disks, or not persistent disks, exactly the same, right? This one actually is my kids' Minecraft server that they run on and play. So it works well across the world. So we access it from Germany. I just want to make sure to show this. There was, like you said, never do live demos. It was supposed to be before the slide. But yeah, it's absolutely identical in terms of Horizon.
There is a slide, the final slide is about the fact that we are hiring a lot. You'd have seen the announcement that we said $1 billion over the next couple of years, so that means a lot of hiring. So if you're excited about what we're showing here and want to be part of this, please make sure you come and visit us in the booth. I think we have a recruiter on site, so we can take care of this. That's the final slide, and I think we have a few more minutes. How much time? 10, okay, about 10 minutes. And we have experts here, you know, from Phil. Do you want to join us for Q&A? Phil and Anu from Public Cloud. Phil is the chief architect from Community Edition. So if you have any questions, we can get it answered directly from the folks who are actually developing this product. So.
Questions? Okay, anybody just want to scratch their head?
So let me take a stab at that under cloud, over cloud, because I saw that looked like there was quite a sort of confusion. So this is a triple O concept, right? I mean, everything we're doing here is mapped to pure things that you'll hear about in the various other sessions that you're around today. The undercloud in this context is a complete OpenStack installation, like you'd be used to if you've been deploying this. The difference to think about there is that particular, the undercloud, is using a Nova bare metal driver, or Ironic, which is gradually replacing Nova bare metal as we get that deprecated. So its job is it runs Nova services, but its job is to stand up bare metal machines that are running an image, and they're getting those images from Glance in just the same way that OpenStack would everywhere else. So that's the deployment mechanism for getting your rack of servers to run a particular stack of software. And the images we're deploying are images that have the rest of the OpenStack components in it. So the undercloud uses the bare metal drivers to build this thing we call the overcloud. And then the overcloud is a complete OpenStack system that's the one that's running your ordinary hypervisor drivers behind Nova Compute. So they're kind of two different layers. They're two separate OpenStack systems. And that's where this whole OpenStack on OpenStack comes from. Sure. Okay. So, yeah. Sure. The question was, we've said that the undercloud is hardware agnostic, and the question was, how do you get that hardware agnostic layer? And again, this kind of comes really from the tenets of the stuff that's built into Triple O and Ironic and those bare metal drivers. They have a very simple set of requirements for being able to drive a host, which is basically they need some kind of IPMI interface to it to be able to power cycle them. The machine's power cycle, the way Ironic gets software on there is through a traditional Pixie boot type sequence. That brings up the system, makes its disks available, an image then gets loaded onto them. So the technology that's used to actually do the deployment is agnostic in that sense. The only thing it really needs to be able to do is to power cycle a machine and the machine to be capable of Pixie booting. In terms of how do you get then support for the whole range of hardware that's out there, that really comes down to what you build into the drivers. As we said, we've got our own hardened OpenStack distribution, which is a Debian distribution. And obviously, we've got to support the drivers that we need to qualify a set of hardware that can be run on there. So probably you could find some hardware that won't have driver support in there, but as long as it's a reasonably recent set of hardware, we'd expect to have all the driver support we need.
And is there flexibility across, how much storage I apply to that, how much memory I apply to that, how many CPUs I apply to that?
Yeah, within reason. I mean, because the undercloud is using effectively Nova to do a deployment, the thing that's defining how you set up those machines are the flavors that you have defined in the undercloud, right? So, the thing that's kind of elegant about this is the reason that Triple O came to existence is when you look at what you need to do to deploy a hardware system, it turns out you have most of those capabilities already built into OpenStack to be able to create and deploy VMs. The only thing that's different is you don't really create the bare metal machines, you import them into the system because they obviously already exist. But most of the other paradigms that you're used to using to build VMs apply to the undercloud. And the nice thing then is all of the management tooling and all of the knowledge you've built up in already running OpenStack clouds applies to the same set of tooling that you're using to deploy the thing with. So it's not like you have to learn a whole new set of APIs and a whole new set of tooling to work in the undercloud from the overcloud.
Yeah, the question here is for the public cloud, are you using any other HP enterprise management systems in addition to the OpenStack release? For example, I saw the portal which had pricing plans and some more. And besides that, what else can you share? I mean, what else are you using?
That's a very good question. Thank you. I think every service provider would come up with their own service architecture, when you deploy OpenStack in production, you still need your service architecture in terms of what do I use above and beyond what OpenStack provides for monitoring. And HP's got a whole suite of monitoring products. HP software produces a whole bunch of monitoring products, and we use them for point purposes. We have our own service-oriented monitoring, which uses vertical technology from HP. So when we run the public cloud, just as any other service provider that would do an implementation of OpenStack will do, to manage it and to run it, we use HP technologies and other technologies. Yes.
Helion today is what was Cloud OS?
So I want to clarify. HP
and also, where's Cloud Matrix?
Got it. So HP Helion is our Uber brand name for all, you know, it's a portfolio of products, right? It's not just, HP Helion is not replacing any one single product. It's just a brand for referring all cloud products from HP. The HP Cloud OS that you're referring to, yes, that's specifically the sandbox is deprecated. Our community edition is moving forward. It's basically a full distribution, so we did not see any need for continuing to allow downloads of Cloud OS Sandbox. We have Cloud OS for Moonshot. That, you know, that is still a product that will continue on. At some point, we'll rename it. But basically, we are moving away from the notion of Cloud OS. It's HP Helion OpenStack is what it is. Cloud Matrix still there. I mean, I don't think we have went and renamed all the products, but that is, yeah.
Yeah. So as I recollect in Cloud OS, you guys used to have this proprietary value-add modules around Eden and Eve to provide things like Tosca models and additional capabilities. What happened to that?
So that's a great question. So today, what I did not talk about today is our full portfolio of products and roadmap. I just specifically talked about Community Edition, which is what we shipped last week. But you will, we did announce last week that HP Open Helion OpenStack is a commercial line of OpenStack products. So we do expect enhanced versions of these products. I mean, more different versions of products built on top of HP Helion OpenStack Community that will have these value-added services that enterprises need for example, bigger scale, more than 30 nodes, right? All of that stuff will come in future products. So, yeah, sure.
So we're looking at how do we take this technology that, as Raj said, works for 30 nodes, and how do we roll that to the public cloud, which is approximately 10,000 nodes. As part of that journey, we are going to contribute upstream the best practices around how do we get this technology to mature. And as part of running the public cloud, just as the question was asked, we have lots of experience in operational tooling in things like how do we do firmware upgrades, how do we do quick updates when there's a security patch that needs to be rolled out, how do we do updates without bringing down the instance, and we're going to take our best practices and contribute them upstream and hopefully drive some incubation projects around some of the operational tooling that needs to come into OpenStack, including perhaps a CMDB at some point. So if people are interested in talking to more about this on getting these best practices rolled upstream, do contact me.
I think we have 5 minutes. Maybe we can take a couple of more questions. So.
Just a real quick question. What are the minimum requirements to run the Community Edition?
So for preview that was launched last week, I think I had it in the slide itself. It runs on Ubuntu 13 or 14. You need, I think, at least 16 GB to be able to deploy a 5-node cloud in a box. More the better, but I would start with at least 16 GB. For experiencing this. And for the full release, we will come out with detailed documentation on the hardware requirements for different nodes, and you know, you should stay tuned for that. Okay? Thanks. Great question. Difference between DevStack and Community Edition. So, so the Community Edition that was launched as a preview is really, it's just like DevStack. I mean, you can deploy it, get it going quickly, experience all of that in a box. we don't support, for example, deploying on a virtual machine today. You need a physical machine. But based on the interest that we're seeing in terms of folks wanting to try out, and we might actually, we might at some point consider, see how we can make it easy for people to try it out, just like DevStack or there's some like TriStack and things like that. But as the future releases come in, I think we'll continue to evolve what we released as a preview, the cloud in a box, along with our full bare metal support. So thanks for the question.
Three minutes.
Who is asking the last question? All right.
Are your slides available anywhere?
I'm not sure about if you're uploading these slides.
As soon as I get the slides, I'll throw them up on the slide share and then tweet it out. It doesn't matter how long it takes the young gentleman up front to email them to me. So all pressure should be on.
If there is enough interest in slides, yes, we'll make it available. Thanks. I think we are about time. Okay, thank you so much for all your interest and attention, and try it out.